Hey, this is fun. It's a Sunday morning and it's the first Sunday of the month, so that means here in France, a lot of things which are of, it's a heritage day, so a lot of things which are of interest are for free. Now this is what's left of the fancy mushrooms we got 2 days ago. And this is a fish, this is a dorade. I think that's gild head in English. And I don't approve of eating fish, but if he buys it and wants to eat it, I cook it. And this is going to be for two people. We're used to eating really pretty small quantities of meat. This is an enormous celery. You know, celery is very expensive here in France. And when this stuff comes back, you know, the dirtier it is, the better. I'd rather see that it comes from real dirt and that it's not been highly processed, and I just have to soak it and clean it. This has got a lot of tops on it, and they have a bitter taste, but they're very good for soups and for stuffing. So I'm cleaning these. These are the bottoms. And I'm going to have to pull them apart and go through them even more to get more dirt off of them. And they'll probably, I would assume I will blanch them, but at least they will be crisped, so I can drain them and put them in something in the refrigerator and they will stay crispy for a while. He spent 5 euros at the market this morning. He got 4 avocados, 3 zucchini, which are called courgette here, a little eggplant, and a whole bunch of potatoes, a lot of potatoes. Very nice. And onions. You know, I have lived twice in places in the world which gave me very little access to fresh produce and cheap food prices. One of them was in Kent, Ohio, where I was a student from 1975 to 1977. And there wasn't a green market, and it was, you know, we the students didn't have really very adequate places to cook. I did live off campus for a while, but you know, getting the actual fresh stuff, we didn't have automobiles, most of us, and so we couldn't drive into the country and buy stuff direct or go to farmers markets in other cities. And when I first lived in New York in the late 70s, I lived in Manhattan originally, there were no green markets. And basically I had to eat just bodega food. You know, you had to go to the bodega and buy, you know, cans of things. And it was very expensive. You know, maybe, I lived in the Lower East Side. There were still a few, there was a poulterer. I could buy chicken backs for pretty cheap and make soup and stuff like that. But, you know, to get, like, quality fresh produce, you really had to have more money and be able to go to the fancy stores, which I certainly couldn't do. I lived on a $5 a day budget that had to give me my transportation to and from work, food, clothing, you know, medicine, whatever I needed. It was very hard. I think that if you cannot get basic supplies and services where you live for cheap, you might want to think about going to live someplace else. And my spouse really does not like Saint-Denis. We've been here for a long time. We bought this apartment in 1994, an abandoned apartment, which we had to fix up, and it's just been hell. And we'll never buy another fixer-upper again, that's for sure. He would like to live someplace else, and we've been looking for years. But we've concluded that we won't be able to have the same cheap food prices and the same excellent libraries, public transportation, the same great location anyplace else that we can think of in France. And it's kind of nutty because real estate prices are terribly high here now, and in Saint-Denis and Paris there. It has nothing to do with anything connected with reality. And for well under $100,000 US, you can buy a really nice house in France in perfectly good condition with quite a bit of land around it. And for $500,000, you can buy a castle with a moat. You know, I don't know what you're going to do for work around there. And if it's in a very isolated place, it may not work out for you. But, you know, it's kind of a catch-22 we're in. And, you know, as grungy as it is here, I still basically like the apartment. Even though it turned out very badly in 2010, I'm glad I had the place properly wired and rehabbed to the extent possible then. And, you know, it is what it is. So this, you know, Sunshine 8308 has been doing some really interesting clips of, he's touring Europe this season. He started in Portugal, he went to Spain, he went to Germany, now he's in Denmark. Maybe he'll go to Greece yet, I'm not sure. But he's putting up little short clips on his channel, and he's spending a lot of time walking around looking at neighborhoods, because this is at least his second time to Europe, at least. And he's kind of not really that interested in the museums and stuff this time. So he's outside a lot, and you might be interested in what he's doing. You know, he's looking at food prices and other prices and talking to a lot of locals about what they do for a living and, you know, how much they earn and stuff like that. Very, very interesting. We after lunch today, we have actually five places picked out that we could visit. It depends on the weather, which is highly changeable here. And, you know, if it rains, we'll probably go into Paris. And we have four different places picked out there that we're interested in seeing. But probably we'll go to Maison Lafitte, where there's a castle, this afternoon. They're closed for lunch, so we're going to have lunch here today, definitely. And if the weather's bad, then we'll go into Paris, and it'll be later in the afternoon, which could be bad on the free Heritage Days thing, but we'll see. You know, it's best to look in advance and get as much information as you can, and, you know, have alternate plans for if the weather is bad or if there's a problem with public transportation, if there's a strike, if you can't find parking, if you drive in. Parking is free on Sundays. Paris discourages people to drive cars in, but, you know, we do it sometimes, a couple times a month at least. So that's what's happening. I think that, see, I've got salt on this fish because it doesn't seem to have heavy scales, but I've got salt on both sides of it, sea salt. And I'm going to rub it gently with my hands, fingers, maybe a soft vegetable brush. And I think I'm going to, I don't think I'm going to blanch the celery this morning. I'll do that this afternoon. I'm probably going to chop some celery very fine and put it in this dish with some butter, a little lemon juice, not much else. And get some of the celery going with some of the onion and a little bit of wine and sort of get that poaching. And then once the fish is rinsed and cleaned, they gutted this at the market for us, but I'm going to check it out a little more. I'm going to put the thing in their whole. And these little mushrooms, I'm probably going to cook them separately in a little bit of butter. I'm not sure I want them in there with the fish and the celery. And we'll probably have some plain rice with it. So, you know, there are always cheap alternatives, you know. There are just so many foods that we don't eat anymore, you know. We can't keep to our budget and do that. So I do have to spend time cooking almost every day. It's really been wonderful for us, avoiding processed food. I don't mind cooking. I do find it exhausting. I'm disabled, but, you know, I just do what I can. And, I don't know, you know, I remember those two places I lived in, Ohio and New York City, when I first got there. It was really hard to find cheap quality food. And just by sticking to the cheap stuff, which was mostly, you know, rice, beans, eggs, onions, plantains, things like that, it was very, very boring. And I'm not sure it was even all that good for me. All right. Hope you're having a good day. Bye.